Yes.
Okay. Namaste and Hare Krishna, everyone. Welcome to this session on practice and theory for PMS. So I will be very happy if some of you are inspired to turn on your videos. That will inspire me actually to make feel that I'm speaking to some humans and not to a computer screen. So please feel free to switch on your videos. Even if you're multitasking, that's fine. You can switch on your videos and we can start the session. So let's begin with some nice grounding exercise to start with. This is just to bring your awareness in the present moment in now, leaving aside all your thoughts for a while. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, just take a break for half a minute. Observe the rhythmic flow of your breath flowing in and out. Just see how your breath is coming in and how your breath is going out. Keep your center of awareness on your breath. And now let's chant three rounds of Omkar together, if you like. Take a deep breath in from. Gently rub your palms together. Create some nice prana. Feel the warmth in between your palms. Bring this warmth of your palms on your face. Opening your eyes inside the palms and gently bring the hands down. Great. So welcome all of you once again. And I'm very curious to know if some of you would like to unmute and share if today's session, especially are you looking for PMS, right? So what symptoms do you face? If that is the case, you must have come here to understand more about PMS. So I'll be very inspired if some of you would like to share, if it's okay with you, can share what problem do you face when we say that, okay, we are in PMS. So anyone would like to share, can unmute or you can put in the chat box. Yes, anyone? I see many females here, hopefully. I mean, sometimes your names are not there. So since this is special class on PMS, would you like to share the symptoms that you face during your PMS, especially? Yes, that's correct, PLE. PMS means premenstrual syndrome, correct. That's a long form. So what exactly happens to you personally if you know about this? Like anything that you, okay, one big pan, I have severe stomach ache, irritability, constipation. Now we are talking, exactly. Okay, yoga for person not getting the period, lower abdomen pain. Okay, now we are talking, all of us. And this is real. I have experienced PMS, I do experience PMS, and I want to share today that how yoga has been helping me sometimes to conquer this battle. I also fail sometimes, to be honest, but still I really want to share how yoga has really helped me as well in conquering this battle of PMS. Yes, headaches. True, that's exactly right. And today we are going to understand and also do the practice. I will highly encourage you, all of you, to also do some practice along at the end. Anger, crying, headaches. I so much relate to all of this that you're saying. What to eat, not to eat during periods. Mood swings, emotional outbreak, irritation, constipation, pain, stomach pain, headache. Correct. I was really waiting for your response, and I'm happy that you have given the response. Otherwise, I was going to share my own journey. I usually never got any physical pain during PMS, but I mostly had lot of terrible mood swings. And I couldn't believe that although being into yoga and doing it, but still sometimes it was so difficult for to manage. And first thing I want to really tell you all that it's real. It's not fake. Because many people around us sometimes we fail to make them understand that what are we going through, and they find it no, it's just too much overreaction. But it's real. It's so many hormonal changes are happening, and we really feel that. And what I used to face the most after my irritation and mood swings was a guilt feeling. How many of you have felt that? That it's okay. I could have not reacted so much. It was not that bad. And I don't know why am I feeling. Every PMS, every month, it's a struggle. And every month I feel this. How many of you have really felt more guilty sometimes in PMS that, oh my God, why did I react so much? Especially those who are suffering from extreme mood swings, right? Yes, when daughter was small, okay. I usually used to feel that why did I react so much? And how am I going to manage this? Is this going to be every month? And it was really, really very stressful experience. And I really want to share some yogic practices that are scientifically being researched now and have proven to be very helpful during PMS, and certain practices that have helped me as well. So today we will be discussing a little bit of theory in the beginning first on what is PMS and how. Apart from yogic practices also. And then we're going to move to the practice part today. So I'll highly recommend all of you to also hit your mat a little bit, or even wherever you are, just find some space. We're going to do a few asanas, which are very easy, safe. And that's the plan for today's class. Okay. So what is PMS? Most of you said that. Yeah, premenstrual syndrome. And what are the symptoms of it? You already mentioned most of it: constipation, headache, mood swings, irritability, aches and general aches and pains before the period starts. And sometimes it becomes extremely overwhelming to handle all of these things. So how yoga is going to help us, basically. So yoga practice, when done regularly, at least thrice a week, can stimulate a good happy endorphins or hormones, which can really help us in dealing pains, aches, and emotional irritability as well. So various asanas that we do overall before the periods, or especially to deal with PMS 1 week before religiously, can also help to improve blood circulation to the reproductive organs, to the pelvic region, which will help us to manage the pain. Overall, regular practice of yoga can also help in systematizing and balancing our endocrine system. And this is the cause, because of the hormonal balance, we experience severity of PMS, which is different to different people. So to reduce that and to balance our endocrine system overall, and nervous system, of course, also to feel peace and calm most of the time. So this is how this is a very general benefit I'm discussing. I'm sure the taste of the pudding isn't eating it. So once you start practicing, you'll realize that how gradually this is going to help you. There have been various research done on specific poses, breathing practices for almost let's say 12 weeks minimum, those ladies were given. Around 65 ladies were researched for this based on a questionnaire. And 93% of them found that they reduced their usage of medication and they had less irritability and anger during this PMS phase with some specific yoga practice. So I also researched on that research. And today I wish to share some of those practices with you, which are part of yoganas and specific breathing practices. So that this is what we're going to discuss today. So definitely yoga can be a big help. Only thing is, please continue staying in this class if you really plan to continue your practice. If you're here today just to hear the class, yet another class, you've been reading, already YouTubing a lot about how to manage PMS, and you've been reading a lot of articles and blogs. But if you're not putting anything to practice, I humbly request you to still not waste your time. Bringing some lifestyle changes and adding this yoga practice regularly to your schedule to see the differences in your symptoms. If you take this as another inspiration class where you feel, oh, okay, I got some information, then it's not going to help much. Okay. So Veenaji is asking, can we do this asanas during periods too? Some of them you can, some of it you can't. So I'm going to tell you when we go to the practice part. But definitely you can do it regularly off the period when you're not on your periods to manage your PMS phase effectively. Okay. So the next, I think I directly want to jump to more of the practical today, because somehow I am convinced and very sure that those of you who have PMS symptoms have already done a lot of research on the theory part, that what are the symptoms and how nicely you all have put in the chat box. So I'm not much worried about theory today. And we're going to go to the practice part. And at the end, again, we'll touch base on little theory on other different lifestyle changes that you can bring about and add certain holistic things to manage your PMS. So I request all of you to wholeheartedly participate in the practice right now. They are very easy postures. Why am I saying you participate? Because if you do the muscle memory of how to do those poses, especially for those who are new to a practice. If you're already familiar with yoga practice, then I'm sure you can make a note of this asanas. Okay, and this recording will also be always available to you. Okay. So we will start with some basic warm-ups. Why warm-ups? Because if we jump to some asanas, then it will be little, some of you may not be used to it. So it's good to do some gentle warm-ups. And after that, we will be doing some specific postures which are targeted towards PMS. Particular breathing practices, relaxation, affirmation, and shavasana. This is the full flow of the class that you can practice regularly to avoid PMS symptoms. Okay, so please take half a minute to arrange your mats or find some different space wherever you are. Take half a minute and we are just going to organize the space here. Okay, I have my co-teacher Ria with me, and I'm going to spotlight her for some demo. So please follow. If you wish to start your video so I can see you, correct you, please feel free to do so if you're ready with your mats as well. So you wish to do so. Okay. So Ria, sit comfortably with your back straight. We've already started a class with Omkar and some grounding practice, if you remember. But so right now I'm not doing it again, but always maybe make a note of this if you have some notepad with you, or maybe you can always go through the recordings in future. Always start the class with some grounding or prayer. Whenever you start your yoga practice, this may sound very insignificant instruction and very general, but trust me, the whole experience of how you start your practice is going to make a very big impact on your mind. So generally, if you're just, you know, you just hit that and you start moving, this is not going to give you any mental peace as such. So make sure you do so. You can chant any prayer of your choice, or you can just chant three rounds of Omkar, or just do a simple breath meditation in the beginning, just for half a minute or 1 minute. This is a very important first step on how you wish to start your practice. Okay. And now from here, you just simply go for neck and shoulder mobility exercises. Very simple to start with. Okay. So let's start with some neck movements. You can keep your hands in any mudra of your choice. Very important to keep your back straight and sit upright. And now from here, we will start the neck movements. Anybody with cervical spondylitis in this case can avoid the chest. Just the forward movement of the neck be avoided. Otherwise, you can do all the other movements with your neck. So now, bring your chin to the chest. Center, roll your head back, center, bend your neck to the left side, center, to the right, center, tuck your chin to the chest, center, roll your head back, center, bend your neck to the left side, center, to the right, center, neck rotations, tuck your chin to the chest and start the rotation from the left and back, to the right, and down, right, back, left, and down, one more round, left, back, right, down, right, back, sorry, I just lost all of you. Okay, am I audible again? Yes, okay. So finish your neck rotation if it was incomplete when I just suddenly disappeared, I guess. Okay. So before, now we will go to more movements, but before that, I just want to again highlight something very, very important, your approach to the practice. And this what helps you in really bringing on the healing inside and outside. So what is this approach? Most likely, we all know some of the asanas and poses that should be done, not done, etc., etc. We are very well versed nowadays because thanks to YouTube and Google. But something that we need to really experience and do it personally is how we approach our practice. For example, if your mind is elsewhere too much, little bit, of course, it will go because that's mind. That's the nature of mind. But if it's too much here and there, for example, if you're planning what to make for dinner right now and doing these exercises, most likely you are having very less benefits of everything that you're doing. What does it mean to be present with the movement? Is you have to really put your experience on all the movements that are happening. Really put your awareness on all the experiences that you are having. That how my neck is feeling when I move it. You don't have to judge it as good or bad, comfortable or not comfortable. But whatever it is, you're just observing it. This brings an amazing combination of body, breath, and mind in harmony. And when this harmony is created, you start to see a lot of changes on physical, emotional, and mental health. So this is applicable to everything, not just your PMS. Even if you're struggling with some other health condition and looking to bring about some well-being through exercise, yoga, lifestyle, you have to be a more mindful person generally. And that approach goes on your mat as well. So since I've shared this wonderful and most important information right now, you please make sure that you apply at least for this practice class. And then, of course, when you again start practicing on your own, you definitely are mindful of being mindful in your class. Okay, so let's do some shoulder movements now. Okay. Simply, we're just going to shrug our shoulder up and down. So bring your shoulders up as you breathe in and down. Breathe out. Again, inhaling up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Last round, inhale up and exhale down. Now you're going to interlace your fingers together and place your palms above your neck. This is also a very good pose if you usually face some back pain, upper back stiffness, neck pain, or frozen shoulders. So for this now, you have to exhale and bring your elbows closer and close and round your back. Very nice. Then inhaling open. For opening, you're going to stretch your elbows apart, slightly arch your back. Again, exhale, close. Inhaling open. Exhale, close. Inhaling open. Exhale, close. Inhaling open. Last round, exhale, close. And inhaling, open, relax. Slowly bring your hands down. Okay, let's move to the asana part now. some of the asanas that are targeting PMS, and generally also everything that you wrote, headache, stiffness, back pain, constipation, mood swings. So in holistic way, they are targeting one or the other areas or the symptoms that you addressed. So this can be your holistic sequence also. If you have learned already more yoga like Surya Namaskar and other asanas, please go ahead and continue it. You don't have to discontinue that. But since today is like an introduction class, we may not be able to go into the whole detailed sequence of Surya Namaskar, etc. But I am trying to target some asanas which are directly will emphasize the symptoms and alleviate the symptoms of PMS. So one important posture is Marjari Asana, the cat and cow, releasing the stiffness on the back. Helps with the constipation issues as well. And brings about flexibility in the hip region. So for this, you all can now come to a tabletop position. Okay. So in tabletop position, please check your alignment nicely now here. This is really important because only then you get a proper stretch to your back and the targeted areas. And as mentioned earlier, please be mindful of your inhalation. Feel the compression and stretch. So keep focusing on that. Okay. So now our palms are in line with the shoulder. So please check that if already you have that. And the knees are in line with the hips. So please check this alignment properly. Anybody having some knee pain because of this, you can always keep some blanket, napkin, fold your mat double and do this. Okay. Now from here, we're going to inhale and arch our back. The arching, we are pressing the back slightly down. We are looking forward or look up. I'm sure you're going to feel some compression now to your back. So keep your awareness on it. Then exhaling, we have to round our back. Suck your belly in, tuck your chin to the chest. If you have any neck issues, keep your neck in a comfortable manner. That is good for you. Okay. Now again, breathe in and arch your back. Breathe out, round your back. Breathe in, arch your back. Breathe out, round your back. Last round, breathe in, arch your back. Breathe out. Breathing naturally. While transiting, you are using the breath as per the instruction. And now relax. You can do up to 4 to 6 rounds of this practice on a regular basis. Just before your periods. This asana can also be done during the periods. Safe, comfortable. So you can do it if you have some pains. Okay? Then another important asana that really helps in alleviating any kind of a headache or brings about stress relief is a child's pose, okay? Balasana. So for this, we sit in Vajrasana. In Vajrasana, you can look at the position here. Anybody with knee problem, however, can skip this because if you have knee issues, then sitting like this in Vajrasana is not advisable. So you can look at the, slightly go forward towards your wall. Our hips are resting on our heels. This pose is also personally very good for digestive health. So this is the only asana you can do even after your meals. Otherwise, we recommend doing asanas on an empty stomach or at least 3 to 4 hours of gap. But this asana can be done even after having meals. Okay, so Riya, you can now take another angle for child's pose. So Vajrasana is a pre-position for child's pose or Balasana. Or Shashankasana. Now from here, we're going to raise our arms up, lengthen our spine, go tall as much as we can. And then we're going to breathe out, fold forward, bring our palms to the ground. And then, if possible, we are going to make an attempt to bring our forehead to the floor. I'm going to show a variation for those who are not able to do this, so don't worry. Let me know if you're not able to do this or finding any discomfort in any pose. There are always a lot of variations available. So this pose, when you hold it for more than 1 minute, 2 minutes like this and stay here, and very good for alleviating the headache. Now slowly from here, you can raise your arms up and exhaling, lower down your arms from the sides. Okay. Now let me show you a quick variation of this for those who are not able to go all the way down. Now, couple of options are, you can keep a pillow in front of you and then you can rest your head on that pillow if you're not able to fill the gap between your forehead and the ground. Because in this pose, it's really important to bring the head down, because that is going to give you comfort. If the head is hanging up, you may not have all the benefits of this pose. So you can also bring your knees apart, keep a bolster and take this. Anybody with even migraine issues, or because I used to get migraine before PMS sometimes, in my PMS sometimes. So I used to love doing this pose and it helped me. Apart from other whole lifestyle changes that I brought, this pose really helped. And if you really have headache and you plan to do this pose, you can also, just like a, how can I say, like a bull, you can move your head to the left and right also a little bit. You know, massage your forehead on the pillow when you're lying down, it'll give you some nice relief and blood flow there. So this can also be done as an option for those who are not able to do the full child pose. Okay. So this can be done. If you suppose you don't want to use any pillow or a bolster, then Rhea, you can keep the pillow to the side. We'll need it for one more pose, so you can keep it closer. And from here, you stand on your knees and go forward like a puppy pose, we call it. So your knees are hip width apart here. So look, what was the difference here? In child's pose, our hips were going all the way down on the heel. But here we are, our hips are in line with the knees. Going to, yeah. Then you go forward, stretch your arms in the front now. And bring your head down. This is also very good for back pain relief, headache, and stress relief. So very good pose also that can be done. Try to hold it as long as you can, up to 30 seconds, 45 seconds, up to 1 minute. Child's pose, this pose, it'll be very, very helpful. Okay. And slowly release. Okay, now we will be looking at two variations of Baddha Konasana, that is butterfly asana. One, I'm sure many of you know, very good pose for overall health of pelvic region, avoiding pains and aches, making our pelvic floor stronger. So very important asana for women at all the different phases, from menarche, pregnancy to menopause. This pose is really good. So first variation is general on the mat. You don't need any pillow. Next variation I'm going to show with the bolster for more relief during PMS. For now, you take this as a general pose which will help you otherwise to strengthen the health of your reproductive organs. So this is where you join your soles together. Again, anybody with severe knee pain usually is contraindicated with this pose. So be mindful of that. And now you have to start flapping, of course, your knees down. Very nice. If you are not used to this practices, it's very new for you, take it easy. These are a sample poses that we are doing. Take your sweet time to go back to the recordings on YouTube and then again, keep practicing few rounds slowly to improve your capacity. Okay. Now we will show you one variation. You can go all the way up to around 20 to 30 rounds of this butterfly when you're doing like this. Now we are doing a reclining butterfly. So reclining means you're going to lie down and do this butterfly. This is again gives a different effect on the pelvic region, especially during PMS. So you have to take a bolster under you. Yeah, let your hips be down and rest your back on the bolster. And now you take a butterfly pose. And you can rest your palms on your around your abdomen, lower abdomen. Now holding this position for longer time is really, really good to alleviate all the pains in the lower abdomen that few of you mentioned in the symptom part. So doing this pose and just holding it. So here, if you notice, we are not flapping. We are just holding it. And that holding itself is going to give lot of, you know, you're going to feel this pose a lot on your inner thighs, but it is very good for strengthening of your pelvic muscles and the health of all the reproductive organs. So holding this as long as you can, up to a minute, 1.5 minutes or so, will be really nice. Okay. And slowly, you can always take a bolster that gives an amazing chest opening also. So, you know, your respiratory capacity of lungs is also improved. You can breathe deeply. Breathing deeply, of course, is going to bring relaxation. So in both the ways, this posture is going to help you a lot physically as well as breath-wise. You can take deep, long breaths for relaxation. Okay. And slowly now you can come up to a sitting position. You can keep the bolster aside. We don't need it now, I guess. So you can keep it aside. The next pose again for during PMS. You can also do this pose during periods in active pain also. This is Setu Bandhasana, the easy bridge pose. This pose is from supine position where you lie down on your back. This is safe for all. Any back pain, neck pain, knee pain, no problem. Safe for everyone. All of you can do this pose. You have to fold both of your legs and knees and take a distance between your legs. Now rest your arms on the ground with palms facing down on the mat. Now, if you are used to doing some advanced variation like holding your ankles, etc., you can go ahead and do that. If you're a beginner, simply rest your arms on the sides with palms down. And now exhale. And as you inhale, you have to lift your hips off the floor. Very good. Hold it. Few seconds, hold it, squeeze your buttocks, open your chest, bring your shoulder blades closer, keep your arms down, and now breathe out and slowly lower down your hips back on the mat. Very good. You can do one more round of this now. Breathe in, up. Breathe out, down. Breathe in, up. Breathe out, down. Relax. So this you can do up to 5 to 6 rounds of this asana, especially if you're struggling with back pain, lower abdomen pain, can be done during periods also to release the stiffness from your back and can be done before as well safely. Okay. And now we will flip on our belly. We will lie down on our belly. This pose should not be done during periods, but can be done otherwise to manage PMS symptoms. And this is a cobra pose, Bhujangasana. This is very good asana to give blood flow to the pelvic region and bring compression to the lower abdomen and release any kind of back pain. Overall, what it does is it strengthens your back muscles so that most likely you will not have frequent back pains during your PMS. So I really don't know the background of everyone who has joined today. So the straight arm cobra can be intense for some who has not done yoga practice before. So let me show you two variations of cobra. The first variation is easy. You can do even if you're a beginner, you've never done, you have a back pain already. The second variation is slightly advanced. So you just watch it and see how you feel. Okay. So bring your palms in the front now, somewhere near your shoulder line. This is a forearm cobra, which means your forearms, like your elbow, is also going to be on the mat. So Koshiji, since your video is on, I can see you. So when you come up, you bring your elbow down. Correct. Perfect. Very good. Yeah. So now, once your forearms are on the ground, somewhere your palms are in line with your head now. And now you inhale, breathe in, and raise your head, shoulder, and chest up. Your elbows are under your shoulders. Okay. Yeah, this is a easy variation. So your elbows are under your shoulders. Very nice. Keep it up. Hold it. And most likely, if you are holding the posture correct, your forearms are parallel to each other, elbows are under your shoulder properly. Then you're going to feel some mild compression to your lower back, which is going to improve the strength of your lower back. And there's a gentle massage happening to your abdominal region. And now slowly exhaling, release. Very nice. Okay, I'm going to show you the next advanced. It's not an advanced asana as such, but definitely if you're still new to the practice, it will bring some strong compression to your back, making you a little uncomfortable in case if you've never done this pose. But I will still show you, but you see the pose first. Maybe you can experience it a little bit if you like. So now you place your palms besides your chest. Elbows pointing up this time. And this time when you come up, you're going to straighten your arms, which means even your abdomen is going to come up. And then you're going to look forward. Now, any discomfort, any point, release the posture before my instructions. Okay, this again really helps to strengthen your back muscles, gives a nice massage to your abdominal organs, lower abdomen, and also very good for the health of your reproductive organs. Now, slowly breathe out and release. Very slowly, fold your arms, bring your belly, chest, and head down. Very nice. Straighten your arms to the side. So in case if you are not able to hold this pose, you can at least do 2 to 3 repetitions of it. So you take the pose, hold for 5 seconds, release, take, release, like that. If you are able to hold it up to 20 seconds, 30 seconds at a stretch. Okay. So that was cobra pose. And now we will be coming in a standing position. In standing position, we're going to learn one asana. This is nothing but a standing forward bend, basically. Okay. So, Riya, are you there? Okay. Asmita, I'm going to spotlight you. Okay, Riya is here. Fine. Thank you. Okay. Now, in a standing forward bend, if you have vertigo, if you feel dizzy, be careful in this pose. If you have slip disc, then also you can skip because we're going to go in a forward bend here. But otherwise, if no issues, can safely be done and helps in stress management because the head is lower than the heart. So it's very good relaxing. And at the same time, it's going to bring some compression to the abdomen and strengthen the back muscles. And most of these poses, see, they were working on the abdomen. So whoever said constipation is one of the symptoms that they face, it's also going to help in regulating this symptom during PMS. So for this position, we're going to raise our arms up and lengthen our spine, go tall, hip width apart distance between both of your legs. Now you're going to, Riya, you can face one side of the room for the side angle. Now you're going to exhale and go forward, bend forward with a lengthy spine. You don't have to hunch here. Okay. And relax your arms completely. Wherever your fingertips reach, let the fingertips reach there. And relax your head also. Wherever it goes, it hangs, leave it nicely light. Now, after holding this posture for 5 to 10 seconds, you can do a ragdoll position here. Have you ever seen ragdolls, anyone? Very loose and nice. They keep moving around. That's what we have to do, ragdoll. Very good, Koshiji. Yeah, you have to go to the left and right, completely loosening your body. Just go to the left and right. If you also want to grab your elbows here and do this, you can also do that. If you want to try that variation. Whatever makes you feel nice. Maybe your loose hands or grabbing your elbows and going to the left and right for around 10 times, maybe 5 times each side is really nice. So this is a variation in standing asana that can be done. Okay. Now slowly come up and exhaling, lower down your arms from the sides. Very nice. Okay. So these are a few asanas that are targeted towards females. Doesn't mean that if you know more, you can't do them or you don't add on to your practice in future as you become regular. You can do this plus more, Surya Namaskar, etc. Okay. Now we are turning towards very important phase. So do not skip this part. Trust me, only asanas are not going to help you. We need to also focus on breathing, relaxation and affirmation, which is now upcoming. So please do not skip this. It's one of the most important part. Sometimes you're so much in pain that you won't be able to do any physical practice. I'm sure many of you must have experienced it. So at that time, your breathing, affirmations, relaxation in a systematic way is going to help you to deal with your PMS symptoms. Okay. So we are going to learn now some pranayam targeted towards PMS. Some of them are not to be done during periods. I'm going to mention which to do, which not to do, which ones. And then we are going to do some affirmations and relaxation that can be done during PMS, during your periods. So it's not that you have to do nothing when you are on menstruation. Many things can be done easily. Okay. So please sit comfortably now with your back straight. One important practice that is recommended for PMS management is the cleansing and dynamic breath of Kapalabhati, the frontal lobe cleansing. Okay, I'm sure anybody with yogic background, I'm sure you're very familiar with the holistic and lots of benefits that this practice has to offer. So how to do Kapalabhati for some of you who are not aware, a quick explanation. In Kapalabhati, you only have to focus on exhalation, active and dynamic fast exhalation. Inhalation happens on its own when you are relaxing. So you don't have to deliberately work on inhaling. You have to deliberately focus only on exhalation. And during exhalation, another action is happening where the abdomen is getting contracted inside. And it happens at the same time. You breathe out and the belly is sucked in. So these two actions are happening at the same time. Okay. So Ria, you can come a little closer to the screen spotlight. You can demonstrate around 3 to 4 rounds of this. Yeah, I can see you well. In any comfortable pose, back straight. And now you can start. Can you unmute yourself so that we can hear your exhalation? Yes, and now start. Okay, relax. Thank you. Okay, so that was Kapalabhati. Now, some contraindications of this practice. Anybody with high blood pressure, which is not in control. If you're on medication, doing just few rounds as much as Ria did is not going to harm you if your BP is in control. But any active heart problem during menstruation, if you have had any recent abdominal surgery, slip disc, then you should not be doing Kapalbhati. Okay, but otherwise, if you think just few rounds with managed BP, just few rounds, not many, then it's okay to do. So let's, maybe we can do a couple of rounds of this to understand the practice and experience the breath flow in this. So you all sit comfortably straight. Okay. Close your eyes. Very important to keep your awareness internal while all the breathing practices. And now slowly you can begin the first round. Just few rounds we're going to do, around 10 to 15 rounds of active exhalations. So just focus on the exhalation and start the rounds, dynamic breathing. Okay, exhale and relax. Okay, take a deep breath inside now. Breathe out completely. Breathe in and breathe out. And let's go for second round of this. Only focus on active exhalations. If you have any doubts or you're confused, you can always put in the chat box or unmute and ask. So let's start the second round. Exhale and relax. Very nice, relax. We are just doing few rounds today, but on a regular basis, you can do up to, let's say, as a beginner. If you're a beginner, you can start with 20 rounds, 25 strokes in one round, and like that, you can do up to 3 rounds of Kapalbhati. Then you will feel some effect. And there is no harm in increasing the rounds also up to 50, 60, even up to 80 rounds in one round, 80 strokes in one round to get the maximum benefits. And like that, you do 3 rounds. Please keep in mind the contraindications that I mentioned and then go ahead and choose to do this practice. You can start your pranayama practice with this. So this is a wonderful sequence that helps not just in PMS, but also overall in immunity building also. It increases the lung capacity. And overall, you'll get a lot of benefits, other positive side effects of this practice. Okay? The next practice that you can do is called as Surya Bhedan and Chandra Bhedan Pranayama. Okay? Because we are balancing the nadis, the energies in the body and mind. So this helps in balancing the energies, physical energy, as well as mental, emotional energy. So left nostril and right nostril is the meaning, translation in English. Of Chandra Bhedan and Surya Bhedan. So Chandra Bhedan means always using your left nostril only to inhale and exhale. And Surya Bhedan means using your right nostril to inhale and exhale. Okay. So for this, you can take a mudra with your right hand. So pressing your two fingers, your index finger and your middle finger. Okay. And then closing the right nostril. We're starting with Chandra Bhedan, just few rounds as a sample. Closing the right nostril and natural breathing now. Whatever deep, like however deeper you can do it, but you don't have to force here. So just breathe in and breathe out through both of your nostrils. In a very relaxed manner. You don't have to force the breath, nor you have to hold the breath. You just have to inhale and exhale. Through the left nostril as much as you can. Gradually, to get maximum benefits, try to always make your exhalations longer. But this comes with practice. Doing around, let's say, 15 rounds, 10 to 15 rounds of this is advisable. And now slowly, you can exhale through the left and close the left nostril now. So we move to Surya Bhedan Pranayama. Here we are only inhaling and exhaling with our right nostril now. Left nostril is kept closed gently. It's not that you have to move the tip of your nose to the left and right. Gently pressing the soft tissue part. And then just breathing in and out with the right. Always, always I recommend, everybody recommends, of course, to breathe in and breathe out with only one nostril. So someone has put, I don't know the name, starts with M and something. Unable to hear, but I think I'm audible to others. So maybe you need to check with your audio setup at your end. So continue breathing in and out with the right nostril. Can you hear me now? Check your audio settings. Sometimes on the left side of the screen, there is one mute and unmute button of the speaker. If that is off, then you won't be able to hear. Or maybe your volume also. Okay, now exhale and relax. So this also you can do up to 15, 10 to 15 rounds to begin with, gradually increase up to 20, 25 rounds of this. Whatever as a beginner, you can add little, it's also give you a lot of benefit, but gradually try to increase around up to 15, 20, 25 breaths in some time. Okay. So that was Surya and Chandra Bhedan breathing. Okay. Another breathing, which is really important is Anulom Vilom. And I'm sure it's so popular and so useful that it is recommended in all the therapeutic application, not just for PMS, because again, this pranayam helps in balancing our endocrine system, our nervous system, balancing body and mind, stress relief. So it is very helpful for managing PMS. And you can also do this practice, even the previous, except Kapalbhati, you can do this Chandra Surya Bhedan and Anulom Vilom, alternate nostril breathing during menstruation also. It's not a problem at all. Okay. So I'm sure many of you already know how to do alternate nostril breathing. I will still explain the technique if some of you are not familiar with it. Same mudra that we took in the previous pranayam, we're going to take with the right hand. Now here we are going to use both the nostrils to inhale and exhale. Okay. So closing the right nostril with the thumb. We always start with the left. So breathe in with your left nostril. Now close the left nostril and breathe out through your right. Now breathe in the right. Close the right. And breathing out to the left. Let's do one more round. Breathe in left. Close the left. Breathe out right. Breathe in right. Breathe out left. Let's do one more round. Breathe in left. Close the left. Breathe out right. Breathe in right. Close the right and breathe out left. And relax. Bring your hand down. Okay, this was just a sample practice. Of course, you should be doing minimum 10 rounds of this. So, what was one round? Inhaling left, exhaling right, inhaling right, exhaling left. So, when you start with left, end with left, it is one round. Like that, highly recommended to do around 10 rounds of this practice. Okay. So it will be really helpful and you have to do it mindfully. For example, you can use some visualization and affirmations combined with this to improve the benefit. You can visualize that when you inhale, you are inhaling all the energy and healing inside of your body from the universe. Because sometimes when fatigue is one of the tiredness, feeling is common symptom in PMS. So, you know, visualize that if you're energizing your whole body. And while you breathe out, you try to visualize that along with the exhalation, you are releasing all the tiredness, stress, tension out from the body. When this breath, mind, and these affirmations are combined together, it can have a lot of miraculous benefit on the whole system. So try to combine these visualizations with all the breathing practices while you inhale and exhale. Okay. The last breathing practice for today that I wanted to share is, again, one of the best stress relief pranayam. So for those who have a lot of mood swings, etc., can apply this on a regular basis. Don't do it just during PMS, but do this otherwise and your PMS will be better. So don't just do 1 week before a period. That will be like a cheating to yourself. Try to do it regularly. And that is Brahmari Pranayam. Brahmari has a lot of benefits in terms of anxiety, stress management, high blood pressure, insomnia. So it's going to calm down your nervous system and a lot of benefits are there. So we will do some few rounds to experience the effect of it. Brahmari is done by inhaling through both the nostrils. And then while exhaling, we have to make the sound of Makara. The last part of Omkar. I'm going to quickly show you one round of it. So you have to breathe in through both of your nostrils. There's a mudra you can add for more internalizing experience. Is either you close your ear flaps here to hear your own sound, or there is mudra, internalizing Shambhavi mudra. Now you can use your thumb to close your ear flaps. Place your fingers on under your eyebrows somewhere. Middle finger on your nostril, to the side of your nostrils, ring finger on the upper lip, and little finger on the lower lip. And then you can do this practice. Okay? So you have to take a deep breath in, and while breathing out, releasing the air out with the sound like this. Continue a couple of more rounds if you are doing it, and you can do it in any setup wherever you are. You can do this few rounds if you like. You can do this at the end of the class, beginning, before sleeping sometimes if you're feeling stressful. So really good practice. You should do around minimum 10 rounds of this also for maximum benefits. Okay. Now we are going to the most important part. So don't rule out the benefit of affirmations and relaxation from your healing. Otherwise, physically and consciously, we take actions of changing our food, changing our lifestyle, exercise. But if it is not combined with some subconscious changes, then you may not see the results at times, or the results are not sustaining. So this is one of the reasons we need to work consciously and also bring about some changes to our subconscious mind. How do we bring changes to our subconscious mind, our internal mind, is when we are relaxed. That time if we put affirmations. So what is the best time of hearing affirmations? Either in a systematic class where you're doing Shavasana, if you have that option, or you can choose early morning time, just as soon as after you wake up, hear some affirmations or write down some affirmations mentally, or you can just hear or repeat them mentally. And another option is just before sleeping. This is when we can bring about a lot of changes even to our subconscious mind. And really the body, mind are going to be in harmony and experience the changes. So that's what we're going to do now quickly in last 5 minutes. We will be lying down in Shavasana. I'm going to take you to the whole body relaxation And once you are in that relaxed state, you just hear the affirmations that I am going to repeat. I'm targeting today PMS. Otherwise, you can choose any affirmation of your choice, any problem that you are facing, or general stress relief affirmations also. Okay. So everyone, you can lie down in Shavasana. I'm sure all of you know what is Shavasana, but still quickly, in case you're not sure, you can watch on the screen here. Legs apart, arms away from the body, fingers partially closed in a relaxed manner. Just for next few seconds, lie down in Shavasana, adjust it and come to a most comfortable state. And now from Shavasana, you're going to bring your awareness to each body part one by one. And you're going to relax it completely. So without moving that part, you're just going to take your awareness to that part and relax it completely. So bring your awareness onto your toes. Heels, ankles, relaxed. Shin, calf, knees, relaxed. Abdomen, chest, relaxed. Lower back, middle back, upper back, relaxed. Arms, shoulders, relaxed. Back of the head, top of the head, forehead, relaxed. All the facial muscles are relaxed. From tip of the toes to the top of my head, the whole body is relaxed. from tip of my toes to the top of the head. The whole body is relaxed. I'm going deeper and deeper into my relaxation. I am relaxing my body, relaxing my breath, relaxing my mind. In this relaxed state, we will hear the affirmations with faith and devotion, resonating all these affirmations in your mind. Visualize as if you're writing these affirmations on the blackboard with your eyes closed in your mind. This pain will pass. With each breath, I feel my pain reducing. I am stronger than this pain. My body is healing. Every part of my body works in alignment. With each exhale, I'm becoming more and more relaxed. I relax and allow my mind to be at peace. I trust my body. I nourish my body, mind, and soul during this time. I believe these affirmations are making a huge difference. My symptoms are manageable. This pain is temporary. I am making all the lifestyle changes to bring about physical, emotional, and mental healing. Gently and slowly wake up your body now. Wiggle your toes and your fingers. Slowly bring your legs together. Stretch your arms up above over your head. Give a nice long stretch. Now exhale, lower down your arms. Turn to your right side Make a pillow with your right arm and stay there for a while. Reaping all the benefits, resonation of all the visualizations happening in your mind. Reaping all the benefits of the movements, breath work and relaxation. Visualize that with every exhalation, all the pain, discomfort, tiredness, stiffness is going out of your body. And with the support of your left palm in front of your chest, slowly come up to a sitting position. Sit comfortably with your back straight. We will chant 3 rounds of Omkar followed by 1 Shanti Mantra to wrap up the practice. Close your eyes, relax your face. Gentle smile on the face, shoulders, neck completely relaxed. Take a deep breath in. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Gently rubbing your palms together, bringing the warmth of your palms on your face, up your eyes, opening your eyes inside the palms and gently bringing your hands down. Namaste. Let us surrender today's yoga practice and the results of the same to the Supreme Lord, expressing our gratitude to all those people who have helped us in lives at some point. Let's pray for the well-being, good health and safety of ourselves, our families and all around us in the world. Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. May all beings be happy. Thank you very much for your enthusiastic participation. I'm open if anyone has any question about their condition or anything from the class that they haven't understood. So if you have any questions, you can unmute, you can ask, or you can put in the chat box.
Hello, ma'am. Which is your YouTube channel?
Govardhan School of Yoga. I'm going to put in the chat box here.
Okay.
So that's the name of the yoga school at Govardhan Eco Village. And the YouTube channel is Govardhan School of Yoga.
Where is it, ma'am? Location?
It is near Mumbai, on the interiors of Palghar. Where you stay, Angel?
Actually, my name is Ruby. My daughter is Angel. Okay. I didn't change the name.
Okay.
I'm from Kerala.
Okay. Okay. So next time you come to Mumbai, then you can probably.
Yes. Once again, could you repeat Govardhan?
School of Yoga. See, I'm sorry. I think I sent to somebody else. I just sent it to everyone again.
Yeah, yes. Yes.
Okay, everyone. Yeah. Okay.
Done.
Okay. Thank you very much, everyone, for your enthusiastic participation.
And the way you were explaining was very peaceful and clear. It was so nice.
Thank you, Rubiji.
Yeah.
So please, all of you, in peace, can watch the YouTube recordings, note down the practices, so that you can do it in a systematic way for this issue. Okay. Since nobody has a question or any comments, we will end the class here. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Hare Krishna, Mata.
Very nice session.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Yes. Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.